Paparazzi caught me hopping out my bag, ayy. Hopping in a Uber on my way to get the bag, ayy. Used to drink a bottle every day cause I was sad, ayy. I hit up my dad like I hope that we...
What's up guys, it's Miles here, and today I am in Thompson Library. I actually got myself a nice study room, as you can see. But anyway, besides that, I want to talk about internships today. I want to talk about how to get your dream internship, because everybody has a dream internship out there. Everybody has a place they usually want to go to. And so today's video, I'm going to be talking about some major things to help you get there. And this video is helpful for college students, obviously, but it's even helpful for people who are in high school, because if you're a high school viewer, this can definitely give you a glimpse of kind of what's to come when it comes to getting internships and kind of how to go about that the most efficient way. I can tell you this much, I wish I knew all this information as a freshman. When I was a freshman, I was absolutely clueless when it came to internships and things like that. Now, the first thing I want to talk about when it comes to applying to internships is definitely applying broadly. You're going to quickly realize that there's a ton of competition out there, and if you're someone who's only applying to like 10 internships, I'll tell you this right now, you're really not going to hear back from a lot of people. The thing about internships is it's highly competitive. Most companies have thousands of applicants applying to the same internship, especially if it's the internship of your dreams. Let's say you want to work for Google and you want to get an intern position for this summer, you can bet that there are thousands of applicants vying for that same position. And so what you have to make sure you do is, while you're on the search for your internship, you have to apply to a ton of places, and I mean a ton. What I'm going to say might come as a surprise to you, just trust me on this, apply to 100 places or even more than that, but I'll say apply to 100 places. And I know that might sound like a big number, really up there, totally impossible, but hear me out. If you break it up into weeks, let's say every week you apply to about 7 places, by the time you're halfway done through the semester, you're gonna have 50 applications put in. And so the reason I say do this high number is simply because if you do this high number, the odds of you hearing back from places really do skyrocket, and I mean they skyrocket. When I started to make sure that I was applying about 6 or 7 places a week, I was getting phone calls back, interviews, things like that. So definitely make sure they take the time to just lay out 5 or 6 or so applications every single week. Also, something to keep in mind during this whole entire internship search is to apply to places that you think you have absolutely no chances of getting into. They really do look at your applications holistically. And so don't ever be afraid to apply to a big company or a company that has a lot of clout, let's say, because you really do have a chance to make it in there. Now, this next thing I want to talk about is probably the most important thing. And if you're going to take away anything from this video, take this one to heart. And it's this: if you're applying to internships, try your best to be able to reach out to the recruiter for that position you're applying to, or maybe someone in HR for that position, or like they have some relation to the position you're applying to. And if you're applying to your Apples, your Amazons, and even, it doesn't have to be those big companies, but if you're applying to a big company, the odds are there's thousands of people applying to that same position. And so one way to separate yourself from the competition is reaching out to someone who either is a recruiter for that position or someone who at least has some type of influence over who becomes an intern. When you're sending an email cold like that, you want to be able to convey your interest in the internship, but at the same time, you need to show that you have some type of value that you can give the company. You know, it does nothing for them to tell you that you're interested in it. Like, of course you're interested in working for them. Like, that's not going to come as a surprise. But what may come as a surprise to the people looking at your email is, hey, I have experience in this specific thing that you guys are currently working on. So what I do is I usually open up an email stating like how interested I am in the company. Maybe I talk about some of the company history and say, oh, like I just learned about this, or I read this like report on blah, 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 and I discovered this. And then from that, I take it to conveying value. So they know that, hey, this kid actually has experience with the projects we're currently working on, and they're very interested in the internship, so much that they emailed me specifically. Usually what I'll do is, after saying that and putting my resume on, I'll end it with a thank you for taking your time to read this, and then I'll say looking forward to starting the interview process. In my own personal experience, I have used that format and I've gotten interviews from it. I've even bypassed the long process of people going through applications in a pile just from sending an email like that. And the last thing that I want to talk about here is the interview prep process. So this one may come as a no-brainer to you. You might be like, oh, like, duh, like, of course you need to prepare for your interview. But this is the thing, though. I mean, like, I'm guilty of this. I'll go ahead and use myself as an example. Even though I know that the interview is the most important process of getting an internship, I'm lazy. I still sometimes will not prepare like I should. And this year is the first year I took time really to prepare for the interview process. And the way I prepared for the interview process I found very effective was simply, first off, having friends ask you questions. It kind of puts you on the spot and it makes you develop answers with someone looking directly at you and kind of like that sense of like you're being timed. I definitely did that a ton, but before I even did that, I got a sheet of paper and I basically Googled the most common interview questions. And yes, some of these are very generic. It might be tell me about yourself. It might be why do you want to work here? It might be strengths and weaknesses. But what you need to realize is that a lot of these companies will still use those basic interview questions in the very beginning, maybe in the first round or second round of interviews. And so this is really good to know those by heart almost. So what I did was I had these questions, made a Google Doc, and on that Google Doc, I would write my answers out. I didn't completely memorize them, but I definitely knew it to a degree where when I'm in an interview, that's kind of like, if you say like, tell me about yourself, I have a response like that. Like, it's not even hard for me. So that is definitely something to do. Definitely crafting responses to interview questions and having a good idea of how you want to present yourself and things like that. I think the biggest takeaway that I've taken from the last few years of college when it comes to trying to get an internship or seeing my friends get internships is that we can no longer rely on charisma to get us jobs. You know, back in high school, it was pretty easy to go to interview without preparation. And if you're a good person, if you're easy to talk to, you'll probably get the job, right? But now in college, that just doesn't work the same way. You really do have to be prepared for interviews. And I'll tell you this much, the people interviewing you, they know when you're BSing. It's not necessarily that the people who are giving BS answers during an interview don't know what they're doing. They didn't take the time to prepare for the interview, and an interview is very fast-paced. So obviously, if you're put on the spot to answer a question, you're not gonna have that much time to think of one on the spot. But if you already thought of one previously, then it shouldn't be any issue. I've definitely had some bad interviews or things I know I could have done better in because I didn't prepare. I thought I was like good enough without preparing, and that was not the smartest decision on my part. So take it from me. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And if you guys have applied to any places, please leave that down below if you're comfortable with that. I'd love to know what my viewers are doing out there. So just go ahead and comment below where you've been applying or maybe what internships you guys have gotten. And if you're in high school, put down your dream internships and things like that, because I'd love to know about that type of stuff. But once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I should probably be heading out to class because I had that in literally 5 minutes. And I already know I'm gonna be late, but it's a recitation, it counts for no points, so I'm not really stressing like that. But thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.